Fuck that. 8 doobies to the face. Fuck that. 12 bottles in the case, nigga. Fuck that. 2 pills in the halfway, nigga. Fuck that. Got a high tolerance
when your age don't exist. What's up? Yeah, this is gonna be a review like this. I did not have enough time to do what I usually do, so you're just gonna have to settle with a low quality camera from my laptop and yeah. Okay, so let's talk about The Virgin Suicides. From the title, I know that you can already tell that it's not going to be a comedy of any kind. It is a kind of a sad, tragic movie, but not to the extreme. It's not a Lars von Trier film or anything like that, it's just a little bit sadder, I guess, than about... Well, the Joint Security Area was pretty, like, sad. And Amour was also... Okay. Whatever. Okay, so let's talk about the movie. It's about five sisters with extremely strict parents. And, yeah, from the title, I guess that you can already tell what's going to happen. It was a pretty good movie, I must say. It stars Kirsten Dunst, or whatever you say, and she's a fine actress. Although I have this like prejudice of her, because I think it has to do with the first movie I saw with her, first role I saw of her, was Interview with the Vampire, and she's so fucking annoying in that movie. So I guess that like that bug has been stuck inside my brain, so whenever I see her, I'm like, oh. But then I get reminded that she, oh, you know, yeah, she's pretty good. The other sisters, I don't know if those actors have been in anything else. I know that one of them is like in Criminal Minds, but that's it. So yeah, Kirsten Dunst is like the main sister. She's the main character in the story, and then later in the film, after one of the sisters commits suicide, it becomes more about her, and then she meets this guy called Trip Fontaine, played by Josh Hartnett, and you know, he's a decent actor, I have to say. I mean, from what I've seen him in, he's pretty decent, but you know who could have played that role? James Duval. Because they look very similar in this movie. I mean, you take James Duval straight from nowhere and you can just have this character. Have him playing the character. It also had, The Virgin Suicide also had a couple of cameos, but I think they were a little bit wasted. Like, you have these great actors who appears in just one scene, and that's it. Like, Scott Glenn. He plays like a priest who just visits the house one time and then disappears, which is such a shame, because Scott Glenn, in my opinion, is like one of the most underrated actors of all time. He's like, whenever you see him in a film, you're not like, ooh, an actor, ooh, playing a character, nice. No, when you see him in a film, you're like, ooh, a character, nice. He's like one of those rare actors, well, not, maybe not rare, whatever. He's one of those actors that, like, you never see Scott Glenn. You just see the character that he portrays. Unlike James Woods. You have to have that kind of contrast there. I think they could've, a switch could have been better, but you know, whatever. It's not really a big deal. Danny DeVito also appears for a brief scene. I think Danny DeVito is a pretty good actor. You know, he's a fine comedian, but I think he holds up in his acting as well. And he only appears in one small scene as well. So that's also kind of wasted, in my opinion. Okay, so that's the acting. How about the rest of the movie? It was directed pretty good. You know, for director debut, it was really good, actually. Like, not maybe the best directorial debut of all time. The movie was also a little bit, again, like, comparing this to Joint Security Area, who I just watched, was really, like I said, tonally inconsistent. That you had this whole... You had one thing, and then it turned to another thing, and then it went back to the first thing. The Virgin Suicides was kind of the same way. Like, it feels really weird because, you know, I just watched that movie and then I go back to this and like, okay, the structure is very, very similar here. Because you first have this the movie focusing on this thing, and then it jumps to this Kirsten Dunst, Josh Hartnett thing, and then it goes back to that first thing. It's, you know, it wasn't like, it didn't really take me out of the movie, like in Joint Security Area. You know, it was, because in this we got like this sense of build up towards something, and in Joint Security Area it was just like, oh, Fox and the Hound, okay? So even though they were kind of, so, and they came out like 1 year apart from each other, so maybe there was some influence there, I have no idea, whatever. There was one thing I didn't understand about the movie though, is there's like these segments with the older Tripp when he's like narrating kind of what's going on. Okay, you have the original narration, which, you know, I can understand that. But then this, like, documentary-style interview with this older Tripp, and I was like, okay, I don't really see the significance here. Now I think it was like a week ago that I saw this movie, so I'm having like a little trouble remembering if they said why they interviewed him. But I don't think they did. So that was a little bit confusing. The Virgin Suicides also had, like Amor, it had one very great scene that I think I will remember quite a long time. It was not as great as that one in Amor. I mean, I'm not going to show people this scene when they ask me why I love movies. But it's still, it's like these kind of scenes, they really appeal to me. I don't know really why. But it's like, oh yeah, I like this. Aura around the scene or whatever. It kind of reminded me of Maps to the Stars by David Cronenberg. They also had, that movie also had those kind of scenes. And I think that may be some influence from The Virgin Suicide, because like you have the little girl, and then you have like the composition of the shot when she's like sitting in weird places. Like it's not a little bit as, it's hard to explain, I just show you the actual scene so you know what I'm talking about. I'm really unsure as to if this is my favorite Sofia Coppola movie or if Lost in Translation is my favorite Sofia Coppola movie. It was a very long time ago I saw Lost in Translation, I think like maybe 2 or 3 years ago, so I'm gonna have to rewatch it again to make that decision. But it was pretty good. I mean, it wasn't as good, it wasn't as boring as Somewhere, and it wasn't as weird as The Bling Ring. So, you know, it was a fine movie, especially for directorial debut, like I've already said. And I don't really have much more to say about the movie, actually, since it's been so long since I saw it now, it's been such a long time since after I watched the movie and to the part that I made this video. And I kind of have to like blame that on myself, because I never didn't get around to doing things like I usually do it, so I have to resort to making this video like this. So yeah, The Virgin Suicide, check it out, I think it's worth your time. It's a fine movie, yeah, let's just leave it at that. And now before I pick the next director, I just want to show you. Because my first Criterion order got home, and I got the first Criterion Blu-ray in my collection. It was The Tragedy of Macbeth by Roman Polanski, because there were only 6 titles available to buy, and this one appealed to me the most. So, and I hope that they release more movies in the UK and in Europe. Like, I really want to get Houzu. It would have been really fun. Or Sweet Smell of Success, I also want to get that. Or, you know, I know it's out of print, but Chungking Express would have been amazing if that had a re-release. And maybe a Blu-ray release of Shortcuts, why not? But I'm rambling on, whatever. Now I'm gonna pick the next director. Haha! Ooh! Yeah, I like this. I have no idea if you're gonna be able to watch to see this. Yeah, it's James Ponsoldt, the director of The End of the Tour, which I really liked. So this yeah. See you. It's gonna be the worst video so far.
I was playing on a survival server with some
Jews? What? Building a field? What?
After a while,
they had everything. After a while!
We have lots of potions.
Please go, Jeb, please.